Would you like to finally get over your ex and move on with your life? If you've gone through a divorce and you want to get over your ex to live a full, happy life, then you have got to stop reliving the past and start intentionally building your future. Martin Luther King once said, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that." You have to step out of the darkness of self-doubt, out of the darkness of regret, if you want to bring that light into your future. Since your divorce, have you found yourself constantly reliving past conversations or arguments with your ex over and over in your mind? Have you found yourself wondering why you still love her and struggling with this feeling of still being in love with her after everything that's happened? Do you find yourself terribly lonely and worried that you might never feel really good again? Maybe you struggle to imagine anything really cheerful or positive in your future, or anything as good as the good memories from the past. And maybe your friends and your family, and perhaps even a therapist or coach, has told you that you need to let her go and move on or get back on the horse. But you have no idea how to do that. The truth is, only men who have a clear understanding of how to let go of the past and how to beat self-doubt are going to be able to move on and build a better life for themselves after divorce. You need a strategy and you need a plan for executing it. Otherwise, you are going to stay stuck, hung up on your ex, and living in that darkness. I'm Rachael. I help men recover from divorce and rebuild who they are so they can get healthy, get happy, and finally move on with confidence. In this video, I'm going to share two things with you. First is the subconscious cycle that you were stuck in that's keeping you hung up on your ex. And second are the two things that you need in order to finally move on, rebuild who you are, and go after that amazing life that is possible for you. What's different about me from the other coaches or therapists maybe you've talked to or worked with in the past? I don't waste your time or mine teaching you positive affirmations, better communication skills, or ways to attract or reattract your wife. Instead, I go deep to the root cause of your fear, of your anger, of your grief, of your self-doubt, and of your regret. I help you handle intense emotions without breaking down and get absolute clarity on what it takes to create a truly successful relationship. So if you've gone through a divorce and are trying to move on and let go of your ex, you are definitely in the right place. Many coaches or therapists will tell you that the divorce was mostly your fault as the man, and your ex might be telling you that too, or that you need to take responsibility for your ex's hurt and pain, that it's really your fault that she's suffering. Just like the court systems can feel like they're stacked against a man in a divorce, so too can couples coaching or therapy feel like it's stacked against you. This leaves so many men stuck, trying to figure out exactly where they failed and how to fix it, but they have so few resources to help them along the way. When you can't let go of your ex-wife, it's because you are stuck in a subconscious cycle. It starts with confusion and pain. Then you progress to internalizing the things that your ex is saying about you or the things that other people are saying about you, which creates more pain and guilt and regret and a lot of self-doubt. That self-doubt leads you to second guess everything you think you understand about what happened, and you end up right back in that confusion and you're stuck in the cycle. It starts with confusion because most men are completely blindsided when their wives leave them. If that's been your experience, it's not your fault. You see, men grow up internalizing some very specific messaging. They learn that a man is supposed to be tough and strong and that he doesn't show emotions. Men learn this from their parents, from movies or video games, from truck commercials, from social media, from kids at school. To be a successful man, to be successful in a career and to attract a good partner, you have to be strong. You have to be powerful and tough. Emotions are literally like your kryptonite if you're going to be a successful man. At least that's what you're taught. That's a message that you understand, and so you learn to stifle and to ignore your emotions. But women, on the other hand, are internalizing a completely different message at the same time. They're learning that they're supposed to avoid conflict and make people happy and be kind and loving and keep the peace. For them, emotion is actually the most powerful tool they have to be successful. So it really should come as no surprise that when people get married, men and women struggle to find common ground. They miss each other a lot. Women rely on their sensitivity to emotion, and men rely on their insensitivity to it. This is why so many men are confused when their wives leave them, because they didn't see it coming. They couldn't, because they weren't perceptive to the emotional cues around them. They weren't aware of the intensity of her emotional experience, and they weren't aware of the seriousness of the problems in the marriage. And then she leaves, which feels really sudden to you, and she often leaves blaming you for everything that went wrong and for the end of the relationship, and suddenly there you are, saddled with a lot of intense emotions that cannot be stifled, cannot be ignored, and you don't have any tools for dealing with them. And that's when that whole cycle begins. There's confusion and pain. There's you internalizing everything that she said about you and all the things she said you did wrong. There is guilt and regret and self-doubt and second guessing and more confusion and more pain. As long as you stay in that state of self-doubt, where you're kind of losing your sense of identity, you can't break free from the cycle, because as soon as you think you understand what went wrong or what's going on or what you need to do, you second guess it, you doubt yourself, and you're right back in that confusion, that pain, and so on. Often, alongside this cycle, there's a lot of like fixing that you're trying to do as well, right? You're trying to fix the flaws that your ex pointed out to you. You're going to coaching or therapy, perhaps. You're joining a support group. You're reading, you're listening to podcasts, you're watching videos on relationships, on how to attract your spouse, on empathy, on emotional intelligence, on how to be a better husband. And the whole time that you're doing all of these things, there is a small part of you in there hoping that she's going to notice, that she's going to fall back in love with you and come back to you. There are actually two fatal flaws at play in this whole cycle that are holding you back and stopping you from moving on. The first is that all of your self-improvement and self-development work, all the fixing, is actually kind of motivated by this secret hope that she's going to come back, that she'll fall back in love with you. And the second problem is this self-doubt. You have lost your sense of self. It's been shaken. And so you don't really trust your own assessments or your own opinions anymore, which means you can never fully and confidently understand what went wrong and how to prevent it in the future. So how do we get past these two fatal flaws? How do we break free of this subconscious cycle and actually move on? There are actually only two things that you need in order to do this. You need clarity and you need confidence. You need clarity on why she left, what your role in the end of your marriage was, who you really are, who she really is, and finally on why you and she say and do all of the things that you did in the past and that you continue to do now. You need confidence about your own self-worth. Confidence in the possibility of a better future, and confidence that you are a good person who is worthy of love. Are you ready to make the shift from second-guessing the past to building the future? Do you want absolute clarity on what went wrong in your marriage and confidence that you can be happier and have a better life than you did before your divorce? Do you want to finally let go of your ex, forgive yourself, and lay out a clear roadmap for success in future relationships? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you're ready, which means you're also ready to finally get comfortable with really intense emotions, both yours and other people's, because that's where real empathy comes into play. You're ready to experience a real system for confidently building meaningful connections without losing yourself as a strong, tough, successful man. You are ready to let go of regret and actually like yourself for who you are. And through that, to finally meet and connect with other people who feel the same way, who like you for you. So here's the perfect next step. I am inviting you, if you're really ready, to apply for a free strategy session with me. In the description below, you'll click the link, schedule a call, and fill out a brief survey. You and I will have a one-on-one private conversation and see if we're a good fit. If we are, I'll explain how my program works and how I can help you rebuild your sense of self, regain your confidence, and move forward to a happier, healthier, a better future after your divorce. I'm going to leave you with one thought to ponder. You are not the person your ex-wife thinks you are. You are also not the person you think you are. Your work going forward is to discover the real you, who you really are, and then start to intentionally create the person you want to become. Because right now, both you and your ex are wrong. You've been through a lot, and neither one of you is seeing you clearly. Because the truth is that you are capable of living a life and achieving things that you can't even imagine right now in this moment. Are you ready to finally see yourself in a new light and see what kind of future is possible for that version of you?